You can play now, we've got you with a guitar, you're playing, you're known, even if you're only working on the sidewalk for dimes and so on. But who was it that you thought, I want to sound like that man?
Well, this is kind of a, I think it's a little bit complicated, but let me try and, when my aunt, that would buy these records that I was telling you about earlier, the teenager, would buy records by Blind Lemon, and she bought them by many other people. That included Led Belly and many others. But something I would hear from Blind Lemon that would just look like go through me like a sword. Well, I heard the same thing from Lonnie Johnson. So these two people, when I was a very small boy, I'm talking about before a teenager, that ring in my head. And it still does. Even today, I carry a tape of Blind Lemon and one of Lonnie Johnson and my shoulder bag with me all the time. But then as I grew up, I started to hear jazz was beginning to creep in the area, like Charlie Christian. And then I started hearing of the big bands, as you mentioned, Count Basie and Joe Turner. I was hearing Joe Turner, believe it or not, way back there. Al Hibbler, Walter Brown, and people that sing at
singers
that time.
As well as guitarists.
Right. Mm-hmm. But those guitarists, the one I mentioned, Lonnie Johnson, Blind Lemon, those were the first that really influenced me. But then I heard of a guy called T-Bone Walker, and man, when I heard of T-Bone Walker, oh, that did it, man. T-Bone was playing
electric. But what was the difference? Because Blind Lemon Jefferson, presumably the same sort of sound that we've already heard from Lonnie Hopkins, for instance, country blues, something along those lines. But what was it about T-Bone Walker that you thought, oh, this is something different?
All right, if you will. Let me see if I can get it, too. All right, now, for instance, Blind Lemon to me was like... Even then, that's why I called him kind of a blues, well, that's the right key. Blues jumped a rabbit, running a solid mile. Something like that. Against. The first would have been the older one. And then the last one was T-Bone Walker. When I heard things like that, man, I said, oh, God, I just got to have a guitar. And that's what made me want to really play.
Yeah, but do you feel that the early guys then were possibly, the guitar was the background.
Yeah.
It was forming
right.
The rhythm. Mm-hmm. And they were singing over that rhythm.
Yes, they sang over it.
With T-Bone Walker, you felt
Single strings and electric guitar at that.
So there's a melodic line that the guitar could sing.
Oh, yes. Oh, man. Oh, God. I was kind of like, when you smell the fragrance of food and you, like in a cartoon, you just float behind it, you know. That's the way I was by the sound of that guitar.
After all I've done for you. but she's not in love with me. I'm in love with a woman, but she's not in love with me. Yes, I love the woman because she's my old time used to be. Baby's done to me. Sometimes I wonder what my baby's done to me. Yes, I love my woman because she's my old time used to be.
So when you heard T-Bone Walker, you suddenly realised this was almost the talking, singing guitar.
Yeah, right.
Not just ching right. While I sing, let the guitar sing.
Right.
You mentioned Charlie Christian just there, of course, was the first great modern jazz guitarist, yes. I suppose, really. I've also read that you were influenced, strangely enough, by a guy who was...
Django Reinhardt.
Exactly, European player.
Yes.
Gypsy player,
yeah,
basically.
Frenchman, yeah.
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 But, I mean, where did you hear Django Reinhardt?
As I mentioned to you about going to the Army, a friend of mine went in the Army with me, but instead of him going back to the plantation as I did, he went on overseas. And he knew that I liked guitar, and he heard, at that time it was called the...
Quintet of the Hot Club.
Hot Club of France.
That's right, yeah.
And he picked up some records, and when he came back home, he brought them. And I've loved them forever. His fingers, they called him three-fingered lightning, it's so fast. And all kind of... that when Charlie Christian would use a lot of time use what we call diminished chords. Oh gosh. I still wind up trying to sound a little bit like Django, of course that's what I
was. What aspect, because of course Django was the blues player, but it wasn't his culture at all, but was it that banding gypsy romantic?
The same thing that you see. I seem to get food from that just as I did the Blind Lemon and the Lonnie Johnson bending up those strings, man. Something. That attack, you know, something about that. I don't know what it is, but it just drives me crazy. I still like it.
Someone you've not mentioned, but I know is important in your life because you've spoken of him many times, was of course a relation of yours, a very well-known blues musician.
Booker White.
That's right, who was your mother's...
My mother's first cousin, two sisters' children.
What sort of a player was he then? A sort of more of a country player?
Yeah, but he was humorous in his music. He reminded me a bit of Spike Jones, if you will. He always could be playing, you know, and like, and he'd talk to you and tell you stories. And he used a bottleneck. He used to take something look like a big pop bottle and break the neck off it and put it on his finger. Or when he didn't do that, he had like a steel bar, something like a pipe, steel pipe, and he would saw a piece of it off. Now today you can buy these things, or I think steel guitar players use it now, just the regular bar. But he would take this and put it on his finger, and he would, you know, if he didn't do that, he could use a knife, just a regular pocket knife, and he would slide it around like that.
So the style is like the Hawaiian guitar.
Yes, right.
You can, instead of using your fingers, you can use a piece of metal or something. And go,
bend
the note like that.
Something like that. Well, I could never do that. I've got stupid fingers, and they just won't work. But I used to sit there and listen to him play, and I loved him. I wasn't so much influenced by his playing as I was of him as a person. He, to me, was a jolly guy. He always had something nice to say. And used to tell me, I lived with him for a year, and he told me, it's always good to try and make people happy. And he said, if you can't say something that's going to be complimentary to a person, just don't say anything. You know? And I learned to try to do that. And I loved him dearly, and I learned a lot from him. Now, he could take that slide and put it on his finger, and he would, you know, make sounds. Like that. And I could never do that. But when I take my guitar and trill my hand, then my ears say, well, that sounds a little bit like Booker.
Well, I tell you what. We've got something for you here, because never mind what your ears say when you play. Here's Booker White on a piece of film, so let's listen to the real man, your mother's cousin.
My mother.